This video is brought to you by Moonfall. Do you ever go outside on a clear night, stare up at a bright full moon, and think to yourself, holy sh**, there's a giant rock circling our planet that at any moment could be thrown off its axis and sent down to cause immediate death for everyone and everything on Earth? No? Just me? Well, guess what? It's not just me. Because the new movie, Moonfall, seems to be playing right into my biggest fears by imagining a scenario where the whole damn moon gets knocked off its orbit and literally starts falling towards Earth. Along the way, it causes a grab bag of damage. Deaths, tidal waves, gravitational shifts, and the like. Now, I'm not here to spoil the movie for you, because that would be what scientists call a total dick move. Instead, we're here to ask, is it at all possible or even likely that the moon could ever be thrown off its axis and sent hurtling towards us like a bowling ball thrown by a drunk and vengeful god? And if it did get knocked off its axis, would there be any hope for humanity? Let's find out in this edition of Science is Hard, is real-life moonfall possible? We really, really hope not. To begin with, let's get some basic moon facts straight. The moon is in an elliptical orbit around the Earth. Its distance from Earth ranges from 362,600 to 405,400 kilometers at any given point. But if it were to be knocked real hard by a massive space object, this could cause the moon's orbit to stretch out and become more and more elliptical as the force of the object slows it down. Now, as you probably know, the moon affects the ocean's tides. Well, this sounds very poetic. It's actually because of cold, hard science. Specifically, the combination of the moon and Earth's respective orbits, speed, and rotation, plus the gravitational pull between the two celestial bodies. And if the moon gets knocked off its orbit, the difference between the minimum and maximum distances between the moon and Earth would increase, i.e., become more elliptical. Along the way, it would also increase the difference between high and low tides and create way bigger and scarier tidal waves. Good for surfers, bad for the rest of us. Because the moon's velocity decreases as it comes closer to Earth, its orbit would get more and more elliptical and eventually start flirting way too close to our atmosphere. The friction created would slow it down even further, and the moon would eventually crash into our planet as its velocity approaches zero. Bad for everyone. Including surfers. But before it crashed into the Earth, the moon would reach an orbital distance called the Roche limit. The Roche limit holds true for any satellite, i.e., an object orbiting something like a planet. This is the point in celestial mechanics where the gravity holding a satellite together is weaker than the tidal forces trying to pull it apart. Now, the moon was formed around 4.5 billion years ago when a Mars-sized planet collided with a yet-to-be-fully-formed Earth. When this happened, they melted into each other and reformed as one body, which is kind of romantic when you think about it. And the moon was a piece that spun off from this new mass, kind of like a baby if you will, thus furthering this intergalactic fairy tale. And when a satellite has the same makeup as a primary body, i.e. when the moon baby is descended from its parent planet, the Roche limit is about 2.5 times the radius of the larger body. This means that if the moon's orbit reached 11,470 miles from Earth's surface, tidal forces would tear that little rascal apart, turning it into a ring of debris. If this sounds familiar, your favorite planet might be Saturn. But in this case, not all the pieces of our blasted up moon will get to stay in orbit, as some pieces will be pulled in by Earth's gravity. If they then survive the fall through our atmosphere, they'll absolutely wreck a few major cities in the process. So it looks like, in theory at least, a world-destroying moonfall is possible. But let's say this all happens, and you're lucky enough to live somewhere that wasn't washed away by massive tidal waves or smashed to bits by a hefty chunk of moon. So, what now? What is Earth without the moon? Well, for an unexpected upside, assuming humankind survived the moon's demise, their nighttime stargazing would be way better, as now the moon, the second brightest object in the heavens, wouldn't be light polluting the sky. So we'd have darker skies and brighter stars, which doesn't sound terrible. Meanwhile, tides would still be a thing, except now they'd be way more consistent in size, and only about 1/4 of the size of current tides. So maybe you'd have to hug a few dejected surfers. So far, this sounds all right. The sky would be filled with beautiful stars, and picnic-ruining high tides would be a thing of the past. But Moonfall is a disaster movie for a reason. A few reasons to be precise. For one thing, the Earth's axial tilt would be unstable without the moon, and this, as you may suspect, is objectively bad. Our normal axis is tilted at 23.4 degrees in relation to our orbital journey around the sun, give or take a couple degrees over the millennia. This relative stability is due to, you guessed it, the moon. For example, pathetic and moonless planets like Mars, clearly our rival planet, don't have this built-in stabilizer, and their axial tilts can change by 10 times as much. But if our moon just plain gave up, our tilt could exceed 45 degrees, which would mean that the Earth would be spinning on its side like a bad high school breakdancer. Poles would get warm, the equator might see snow, and without the moon's stability, ice ages would hit different parts of our world every few thousand years. That all might be enough to send even the most sober astronomer into a frenzy. But let's step back for a second. How likely is it that a real-life moonfall could happen? Frankly, not that likely. A catastrophe on the level seen in Moonfall would require a massive force to slow the moon down enough to cause a significant effect on the bonds between the moon and Earth. For example, even if the largest asteroid we know about, Ceres, which is 294 miles across, could slam into the moon, it would only leave a crater behind. And even a celestial body the size of the moon wouldn't drive the moon down to Earth. It'd just straight up destroy it. So I wouldn't lose any sleep over it. Yet. But even if the events of Moonfall are extremely unlikely to ever transpire in an off-screen reality, the film gets plenty right in its representation of lunar devastation. Specifically, the way it represents the effects of the moon going out of orbit and heading towards Earth are pretty accurate. If that were to happen, and good God we hope it doesn't, the types of flooding, tsunamis, and destruction from falling moon bits in the film will probably follow. And don't worry, we're not spoiling anything that you haven't already seen in the trailer. And sticking with our no spoiler policy, we can confirm that the movie does accurately explain and portray the Roche limit. Now that you know that, you'll be the only person in the theater who can now point at the screen and say something like, "Oh yeah, that right there? Classic Roche limit stuff." Everyone in the theater will hate you, but who cares? Because you'll be right. So, is a real-life moonfall possible? Technically, yes. Is it likely that it's going to happen? Absolutely not. Are we going to tell you precisely how it all goes down in the movie? Of course not. But you can check it out in theaters now and see for yourself on the big screen. And a big thanks to Moonfall and the team at Lionsgate for sponsoring this video. In the meantime, I'm going to head outside and stare at the moon and try to convince myself that it's never going to come for me in the middle of the night. Thanks for sticking around for another Science is Hard, and if there are scientific questions you need answered, let us know in the comments. Thanks as always to our patrons. Be sure to check out our podcast, and we'll catch you next time on Science is Hard. I'm gonna go.